Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 1.11 that is taken from chapter number 1, Stress, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. And the topic is average shear stress. So statement is the inclined member in figure 1-23A is subjected to compressive force of 600 pound. Determine the average compressive stress along the smooth area of contact defined by AB and BC and the average shear stress along a horizontal plane defined by DB. So you can see this is figure 1-23A and there is a compressive stress of force of 600 pound Newton load. So you have to determine the average compressive stress at this surface and at surface BC. And in second part, average shear stress along the horizontal plane DB. So at DB, you have to find the average shear stress. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that what if I remove this portion and represent only this element where there is a 600 pound Newton load is applied. So I have drawn the free body diagram over here. And when you remove the second portion, this portion, so you can see there is a compressive force FAB which is acting on this side AB, and there is a compressive normal force of FBC which is acting upward. Both are compressive. So we will find this FAB and FBC by using equation of equilibrium. So I will write internal loading and the equation of equilibrium is first one is sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to zero and force in this direction is taken as positive. So you can see the force in this direction is positive, which is FAB. So I can write FAB, which is not known. And this, you can see this force will have two components. One is this one and the second one is this one. So this component will be equal to FAB cos of theta. And you can see that if this is the theta, clear? So cos of theta is 3/5. So I can write it that it is in negative direction. So minus 600 into cos of theta, and cos of theta is 3/5. Okay, is equal to zero. So from here, when you solve this, you will get FAB come out to be 360 pound. This is the force, compressive force acting on side AB. Now for BC, we will use another equation of equilibrium that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So FBC is acting upward, so I can write plus FBC, and this component, this 600 pound will have two component. One will be downward. So this component will be equal to 600 into sine of theta, and if you get theta is this one horizontal, with horizontal, so it will be 4/5. Sine over theta will be 4/5. So I can write minus 600 into 4/5 is equal to zero. So when you solve this, you will get this FBC comes out to be 480 pound. Okay. Now for finding the compressive, average compressive stress. So I will write average compressive stress. So alongside AB, average compressive stress AB is equal to force AB divided by area of side AB. So force in AB is 360 pound. So 360 pound divide by what is the area. So you can see this is side AB, its height is 1 inch and the width is 1.5 inch. So area will be equal to 1 × 1.5 there. And when you solve this, you will get the answer will be equal to 240 psi. So I can write average normal compressive stress is 240 psi. Same, we will find this average compressive stress in portion BC. So average compression stress in portion BC is equal to FBC divided by area of BC. So stress in force FBC is 480 pounds. So 480 divided by what is the area? So you can see this BC is this area. This is BC. So this area. So 2 multiplied by 1.5. So I can write 2 multiplied by 1.5. And when you solve this, you will get the average compressive stress in portion BC comes out to be 160 PSI. So sigma BC is 160 PSI. So these are the answer of our first portion. Now in second portion, it is asked that find the average shear stress along horizontal plane defined by DB. So you can see this is DB plane, clear? And you see that the average compressive force on this side AB is this one. So as per Newton law, this component will also exert same force on this block in this direction. And this force will be again, this is sigma, this force AB will be 360 pound. 360 pound. So we will draw the free body diagram of this block. So if I draw the free body diagram of this block, it will be like this. You can see in a while. Okay. So this is the block. You can see I have drawn this block. So the force acting on this is in this direction, which is FBC, and this FAB. And this FAB is equal to 360 pounds. So as a result, on this lower base, there will be a shear stress which will be in this direction. So if I draw dotted or hidden edges, so the shear stress will be in this direction. This will be V. Clear? Now we will find this V by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to zero. So from this we can see V minus 360 pound is equal to zero. So this shear force V will be equal to 360 pound. Now what will be the average shear stress? So we know that I will write it average shear stress. So we know that average shear stress is equal to shear force divided by its shear area. So shear force is how much? This is 360 pound divided by what is shearing area. So shearing area is this one. Or if I represent it, so this is the plane and this will be the shearing area. So shearing area is 1.5 multiplied by 3. So I can write 1.5 multiplied by 3. And when you solve this, you will get average shearing stress is 80 PSI. So average shearing stress is 80 PSI, which is the answer of our this question. So if you want to plot the stress distribution on this face BC and AB, you can also plot. And if you want to average shear stress distribution on this, so you can also draw it. So let me draw it as well. So I will take the copy of this figure there and I will paste it over here in order to show you the stress distribution. So if I make it a little larger and if I remove this force like this, so on this face you can see your stress will be like compressive. So the stress will be like this. You can see this will be compressive at each point. This will be compressive, and same here on this side it will be compressive, and this will be sigma AB, and sigma AB was 240 PSI. Same is the case for sigma BC. If I draw below another triangle rectangle like this, let me choose another color. Clear? So your stress will be this one. In below portion, it will be compressive one. Clear? And this will be sigma BC, and that will be 160 PSI. And if you want to represent the shear stress in this plane DB, so this will be the shear stress distribution on this plane, and this shear stress will be equal to, every shear stress is 80 PSI. And that is all about the stress distribution. This stress distribution for average compressive stress for side AB and BC, and this is the average shear stress along this shear plane of DB. And that was all about this example 1.11. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from this. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.